So you've encountered this error saying that your WordPress site is missing a temporary folder. What should you do? What's the cause of it? Let's find that out in this video. Let's go. Hey, it's Jack from RankMath, the one WordPress SEO plugin that constantly strives to provide you with the most cutting-edge SEO tools. And on this channel, we are all about sharing the most useful and accurate SEO knowledge. So if you haven't subscribed to our channel yet, consider doing so. So what is the exact cause of this missing temporary folder issue? Well, whenever you upload an image, theme, or plugin, by default, WordPress stores the data in a temporary folder. And when WordPress can't find that folder, the site typically runs into this error. Every WordPress installation is different for each web hosting platform, and they may name the temporary folder differently. So to simply fix this without contacting your web hosting provider, the big picture is to create a temporary folder and tell your site where that folder is. But practically, how should you do it? Let's find out. You see, currently the site is having this issue. So to fix this, the first thing you need to do is to go to your file manager, either through your cPanel, FTP, or whatever platform you use to manage the files of your site. And it's just like the files and folders on your computer. It works the same way on your site. So go to the file manager. You see, each of my sites has a folder of its own, and all the files related to the site are stored in the folder. If you only have one website on your web host, all the files related to your site should be stored on the root folder, which is right here, after the home, the base of everything, just like the C drive of your computer. So assuming you have multiple sites hosted on your server, the first thing you want to do is to visit the sites folder. And in the wp-config.php file, before you do anything, you want to make a backup of it. So right-click and download the file. If anything goes wrong, all you need to do is to upload the downloaded file and overwrite it. All right, back to the file manager of the site. Let's right-click and edit the wp-config file. It's giving you a warning, but you already have a backup. So let's hit edit. Now at the bottom of the file where it says, "That's all, stop editing, happy publishing," you want to paste a line of code above it. This is the code to tell your site where the temporary folder is going to be. I've left this code in the video description as well, so you can just simply copy it from there. So if I put TEMP here, the folder I'm going to create needs to have the same name as this. And I need to put this temp folder in the WP content folder. Let's save changes. Now the next thing we need to do is to create the temporary folder. So on your site's folder, go to the WP content folder and add a new folder. You've got to name it the same way you have provided in the command you have added earlier. Click on create new folder. One more thing you want to check is the permission of the folder and its parent folder, which is the WP content folder. Right click on the folder and check its permission. You want to make sure that the user has full permission that gives a number 7. The group has the read and execute permission that gives the number 5, and the world has the same permission as the group. So essentially 755. The same needs to be applied to the temp folder you have created. So these are all the steps. You have added a line of code in the wp-config file that tells your site where the temporary folder is, and we have created the temporary folder. Now let's visit the site again, refresh it, and let's add that file again. It should work now. So that's how you solve the missing temporary folder issue on a WordPress site, and I hope that you have solved it too. If you still have issues after following the steps, you may want to contact your web hosting support and have them fix that for you. Anyway, if you find this video helpful, do help us by smashing that thumbs up button and do subscribe to the channel to get the most updated knowledge about SEO. This is Jack from RankMath. Stay awesome.